There are two ways of looking at this. Why is my memory so bad? Or how am I so good at creative storytelling? Because so much of what you remember never happened. And even though it never happened, we're still able to convince ourselves that yes, it really did. We are masters of deception, and yet we're also the fool being deceived. Whilst there are many funny situations where family members vehemently disagree about a certain run of events that everyone can remember as if it were yesterday, but everyone remembers it differently, there are also quite serious implications of false recollections, especially when thinking about eyewitness statements and their use in a courtroom. A classic study of false recall comes from Bartlett in 1932. In his book, Remembering, he details a study informally known as the War of the Ghosts study. In Bartlett's study, participants were read a strange story about two men from a place called Egulac. They were then asked at several follow-up points to retell the story as they remembered it. And whilst Bartlett noted a good degree of accuracy in the participants' recollections, there were certainly differences from the original tale. But a big criticism of Bartlett's story is that it was just too weird and unusual, and therefore it lacked ecological validity. So other researchers have taken Bartlett's initial question concerning falsely constructive memories, and they've made the research method a little bit more lifelike. A couple of studies in 1977 and 1980 by Spiro are really great at showing how we can embellish memories whilst remaining convinced that we're faithfully recalling the original run of events. In Spiro's study, participants read a story about an engaged couple in which the man doesn't want children. Half of the participants read that his fiancée was upset by this, as she does want children, whereas the other participants read that she also didn't want children. Having read the story and completed a comprehension activity, the experimenter then collected in the answer sheets. Whilst collecting the answer sheets, the experimenter either said nothing at all or made a casual comment about the couple in the exercise. When the experimenter made a comment, he told the participant that it was a true story, and he added that the couple are now either happily married or that they've now broken up. 2 days, 3 weeks, or 6 weeks later, the participants were called back and asked to recall the original story. Those participants who were asked to recall the story 3 or 6 weeks later tended to remember information that resolved a conflict in the story, but wasn't actually included in what they originally read. For example, those who read that the lady wanted children, the man didn't, and then were told by the experimenter casually afterwards that they're now happily married, invented details in the story to iron out this potential conflict, such as they decided to adopt a child rather than have one of their own. In cases where the couple both didn't want children, but the experimenter had casually dropped in that they'd broken up, participants often added details such as a problem with one of their parents as the cause of the breakup. In contrast, participants who heard an ending that was consistent with the story that they'd read, or weren't told an ending at all by the experimenter, didn't falsely recall any extra facts, because the story already made sense to them. Funnily enough, people were more confident about the added facts than those that they'd accurately recalled from the story. So it just goes to show that even if you're super confident that you've got a fabulous memory, you might be tricking yourself into believing a piece of your own neurocreative writing. If there are two key take-home messages from this finding, it's that you shouldn't go and beat yourself up if you're struggling to remember something accurately, because none of us really can. And the second is don't be too stubborn in defending your recollections of an event, because ironically, it seems that the more convinced you are of your recollection, the more chance you've imagined it. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up to let other people know about it. And if you've just stumbled upon Psychology Unlocked, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.